So if you're playing the Witch Doctor class and you're pushing your greater rift levels, you should know by now that the LON Legacy of Nightmares fetish build with the Carnevil Helm is the best way or the best build to be pushing those higher greater rift levels. Now, if you haven't already watched my build video, check that out. I've got some gameplay examples as well where I'm pushing over GR100 with that specific build. And a lot of you probably will be after the speed farming version of that build, and that's what we're doing right now. We're going to go through a speed farming variation, or a variation of the LON fetish build that's going to be ideal for Nephalem rift farming, bounties, whether it's in groups or solo play. As long as you're not doing greater rifts, this is going to be your go-to, and it's going to be very easy to actually get the gear required because it's so similar to the actual LON GR pushing version that there's only a few changes here. And the most notable is the Boon of the Hoarder gem here, as far as the gems go. But anyway, we're going to get into the gear in a second. Let's just go through skills really quickly first. So for primary, we're using Poison Dart with Spine Dart. I've got the Gargantuan here with Humongoid. We're using Fetish Army with Devoted Following, Soul Harvest with Languish, Spirit Walk with Severance, Summon Zombie Dogs with Leeching Beasts. We're using, for passives, we're using Confidence Ritual, Fierce Loyalty, Midnight Feast, and Fetish Psychophant. So, of course, the fetish are what's going to be doing most of our damage here. We're going to try and fly through this today because I find that I'm usually very lengthy with my build videos. If you want to check out an actual written version, I'll have a link down below in my description. Just click on the D3 planner. If it's not there straight away, as soon as you watch this video, it will be. I'll just update it accordingly. But hopefully, as soon as I upload it, I'll have that ready to go as well. So, for the gear for the helm, we're using Carnevil. For amulet, we're using the Hellfire Amulet. Achilles Cuirass with a chest piece. Shoulders, we're using Pauldrons of the Skeleton King. For the gloves, Tasker and Theo. For the belt, Gold Wrap, which is a change from the actual GR pushing version. Lacumba's Ornament here for braces. The rings, we're using the Short Man's Finger and also Convention of Elements. The pants, Depth Diggers, and Sacred Harvester for the main hand weapon here. Boots, Illusory Boots, and Thing of the Deep. Another change here for the speed farming version, or the Nephalem rift farming version, bounties, whatever you want to call it. This increases your gold pickup by up to 20 yards. Super handy, because we've got the Boon of the Hoarder here equipped. Basically, chance on killing an enemy to cause an explosion of gold. And picking up that gold also increases movement speed by 2 seconds as we keep picking up gold. Because everything's going to be dropping gold as we're killing it, we're going to keep picking it up. And also we're going to be benefiting with Gold Wrap here, because on gold pickup, we gain armor for 5 seconds equal to the amount picked up. So we're going to be getting a lot more gold dropped. 100% chance, so it's definitely gold, more gold is going to be dropping. We're going to be picking it up, which is going to be even easier because of the pickup radius is going to be increased here by the Thing of the Deep. And then, of course, with Gold Wrap activating that increased armor. So very, very handy there. For the gems, I'm using the Diamond Gem here. Make sure that you try and upgrade it to the Flawless Royal. Topaz Gems everywhere else. And that's pretty much it. For gear, the same things apply as far as, you know, with your shoulders, try and increase fetish army damage by 14%. With your helm, go for intelligence, vitality if possible, and crit damage. With your Hellfire Amulet, make sure obviously that it's an ancient, because this is benefiting from the LON Legacy of Nightmares seasonal buff. So we're going to be increasing our damage by 750% per ancient item. So all of my items are ancient. But you also want to make sure that you have a very handy passive there. So Pierce the Veil passive is definitely something we'd be using for this build anyway. So it definitely suits us there. Very fitting. It can take you a while to farm the perfect ancient Hellfire Amulet. If you're very lucky, you'll get a primal. But not only do you have to farm an ancient, you also have to make sure that you get one with a very useful passive. And if you don't know already, you can't actually go into Kanai's Cube and reforge this legendary item at all, because it's crafted. You have to keep crafting it. For your Lacumbas, or you can also make sure, with the stats wise, critical hit damage, critical hit chance, obviously super important. Intelligence, attack speed is great as well if you can get it, and also poison damage by 20%, which also goes for the same goes for the braces here. The Lacumba's ornament go for 20% poison damage, and then intelligence, vitality, critical hit chance. What else should I mention here? Tasker and Theo, we want attack speed and crit. So you pretty much want to target attack speed, critical hit chance, critical hit damage, whenever, wherever possible. And then for your amulet and for your braces, try and go for 20% poison skill damage as well. It's easier said than done. Obviously, it's luck of the draw as far as rolling the items go and the stats that you get that come along with it. But, you know, you just definitely want to prioritize attack speed, crit chance, crit damage, and of course, intelligence is the main one here. Poison dart damage for your pants, make sure you put that in there. Fetish army damage for your chest, make sure you put that in there as well. And other than that, everything else is pretty straightforward here. Make sure for your soul harvester or for your main hand weapon, you should always have an emerald gem in there, a flawless royal emerald gem, which increases your critical hit damage by 130%, and that boosts your damage big time. Doesn't matter what type of build or class you're playing in this game. The legendary gems we are using, like I mentioned, Boon of the Hoarder. This you can rank up to a maximum of 50. You cannot level up this gem after 50, so it's going to be pretty quick. You can just farm some Greater Rifts, level this up to 50. If you're not sure where to get it, you have to kill Greed, which is found in the vault. So if you've got puzzle rings, whack them in Kano's cube, transmute them, and you get a portal to the vault. And that way, when you complete the vault, Greed is guaranteed to drop you the Boon of the Hoarder the first time you kill him. We're using Simplicity's Strength here, and also the Enforcer for our pet's damage. So Enforcer, Simplicity's Strength, and also Boon of the Hoarder. So as you can see, it's mostly a lot of the same items that we use for our GR pushing build, but just a couple little changes here with gold wrap, also the gem here, and also the offhand we're using, Thing of the Deep. They're the most notable changes that I could think of, and it's really not too difficult and definitely very easy to transition from pushing your GR and then finding a group and doing some speed Nephalem rifts or bounties, whatever the case may be. You'll definitely do very well here. So moving on, in Kano's Cube, we've got for the weapon Dagger of the Darts, obviously increasing our poison darts damage, Mask of Jaram increasing pets damage, and for jewelry I'm using the Tall Man's Finger, which basically will summon one huge gargantuan dog that has more health and does more damage than all of our other dogs combined. So we're going to be generating a bit of health back because it's got the leeching beast's rune there. So as you can see, I got Tall Man's Finger and Short Man's Finger, so my gargantuans are going to be doing a lot of extra damage, and they split into three smaller gargantuans, whereas the Tall Man's Finger allows me to summon one bigger dog. So we're amplifying the effects of both gargantuan and the zombie dog there. And not to mention, we're also using our fetish army here. Instead of relying on over time gradually building them up, we're just going to be dropping them straight away, and that way they're going to be shooting poison darts whenever we do. See that? And because we have the fetish psychovance passive, as soon as we keep shooting all these poison darts, we're going to start getting more and more fetish psychovance. So it works very, very well. What else do I have to go through? Paragon points. We've done skills, we've done the items or the inventory, we've also gone through Kano's cube. So Paragon points, make sure your movement speed is capped at exactly 25%. That includes whatever bonuses you might have on your gear and combined with your Paragon points. So I've got 11% on my boots, I think it was, on my gear. So 14% here in Paragon points will equal 25 maximum. Everything else into intelligence. With your offense, definitely with this build, pump your points into attack speed first, then critical hit chance, critical hit damage, cooldown reduction last. With defense, go to resist all, armor, life, then life regen. As you can see, I'm completely maxed out. So if you're maxed out and you're above, like, what is it, 800 Paragon, you'll max out all of your Paragon points or all of your abilities here. So it doesn't really matter. Just, you know, pump your points into it. Utility, we definitely want to go with area damage, resource cost reduction, life per hit, and then gold find in that order, and that's basically it. Like, if you need more information, check out the D3 planner link. That will give you everything you need to know, and you can click on things and actually see it on your screens, as opposed to me just going through it, because you can't hover over all of these items whenever you want to. You just have to watch me do it, so it's not very handy. So just open up the description below and then click on the D3 build link, and then you can actually hover over and check out all of the stats required. You can take your time and have a look at it all properly. It'll all be there right in front of you with all pretty pictures and stuff like that. So as far as the gameplay goes, you summon your pets and you kill shit. So as you can see, make sure that you summon your Gargantuan and Zombie Dog as soon as you go in there. Or Zombie Dogs, but they just combine into one. Make sure you get your Soul Harvest stacks up. Fetish Army whenever it's active, or whenever you come across an Elite Pack, make sure you activate your Fetish Army. I'm not playing this live right now. This is something I've prepared earlier, just moments before. I just ran a very random Nephalem Rift. I'm just showing you all. See how easily you pick up all that gold because of the Thing of the Deep? It increases your radius, your gold pickup radius. So you're picking up gold, you're increasing your movement speed, and at the same time, you're also increasing your armor. So you've got survivability, you've got movement speed. Just keep on moving through, keep your soul hover stacks up. Otherwise, just keep shooting poison darts when you come across the Rift Guardians and Elite Packs and Fetish Armies up. Just activate that. It gives you a much better start as opposed to the GR pushing version, because you've got Fetish Army. So as soon as you come into a brand new Rift or doing bounties, you can just summon your Fetish Army, and that way you start. You've already got some there ready to go, so it's a lot easier. It's much easier to start with. But having said that, even with the GR pushing one, it doesn't take long with Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. Use Spirit Walk, Soul Harvest as many, get as many Soul Harvest stacks up as you can, and then you just start shooting away your poison darts, and you slowly generate those Fetish Psycho fans, and then you become practically unstoppable. Depending on what Paragon level you are, and how good you are, and what gear you have. It definitely is the best GR pushing build. So for those of you that haven't checked out my LON Legacy of Nightmares Fetish GR pushing build, you definitely can. I'll post this on my outro. I'll have a link on my outro video, or when my music kicks in and I say goodbye, like when the music kicks in, I'll definitely have a little box there that you can click on in a moment now, and you can check out the Fetish Psycho Fant Carnevil LON GR pushing build. It's definitely the best for pushing GR. There's nothing that compares to it. As far as the leaderboards go, there's nothing that even comes close to the LON Fetish build for pushing those GR levels as high as you possibly can. I hope you enjoyed the speed farming version of this. This will definitely get you through if you're aiming to really push those GR levels, which most 90% of people are during their seasons. You want to push the highest Greater Rift as possible. This is definitely a good variation once you're taking a break from GR, or if you need more keystones or whatever the case may be. This is a great variation because there's minimal gear changes. You just change some skills around, change Kenai's cube a little bit, add some gear items in there, change one gem, and you're good to go for speed farming. It makes life a hell of a lot easier because, frankly, with the GR pushing version of the Fetish build, it's very difficult to sort of keep up with other players if you're doing group play, and it's also a pain in the ass to keep trying to slowly generate all of those fetish around you. It works well in high level Greater Rifting, but not so much in bounties and Nephalem rift farming and things like that. So this build will definitely help you, and it can also assist you if you're aiming to push higher GR. At the same time, you can make a couple changes and make like a secondary variation build of the fetish for your speed farming. So I hope this was helpful. Give me a big thumbs up and a comment down below if you enjoyed this. If you have any questions, definitely give me a shout out down below. Ask away. I will definitely do my utmost best to help you as soon as humanly possible. But until next time, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Click that notification bell, and that way you'll be notified each time this ugly, hairy face is about to pop up with a brand new video upload. Definitely looking forward to seeing all you beautiful, creepy people again real soon.